Hi, this is JP from Northern Lights over Arkham. This time we are playing the Infiltrate the Museum scenario from the Galaxy's Most Wanted expansion. The collector is trying to stop us from getting the Infinity Stone that he has collected. And let's first talk about that we are playing the prebuilt decks from the box. So Rocket Raccoon is playing with the aggression prebuilt deck and Groot is playing with the protection prebuilt deck. We are playing on standard difficulty and this is set up in standalone gameplay, so I am not playing as a campaign. So if you're playing on as a campaign, there are some steps in the rulebook you need to do when you're setting up these campaign games, but we are playing on standalone just to demonstrate which kind of scenario this is and how the decks work in this scenario. So let's get started. I have already set up the scenario, except that the setup forces us to pick one card from the top of each player's deck and place it in the collection. The collection is a special gaming area. I've set it up here and put one villain card face down to indicate where the collection is. The setup rules just tell you to set up an area to be as the collection, and it should be set up so that every player can reach it easily, and because they have to be able to manipulate with the collection during the game. So we are placing two cards and these are placed face up to help me differentiate with the cards on which deck they are from. This side has the Rocket Raccoon cards, this side will have Groot cards, and I'll place the encounter cards over here on top. Talking about the collection, we've done the setup, so let's look at the 1B side of the main scheme. So there is a hero action. Choose to either exhaust your hero or spend two resources of any type. Discard one card from the collection to its owner's discard pile. Limit once per round per player. If there are at least 5 cards per player in the collection, or if this stage is completed, the players lose the game. So how you lose cards into the collection, by playing events and stuff like that, you or using resources, you don't lose the cards into the collection. But if you have a upgrade in play that gets discarded for some reason, it goes into the collection. Also, when defeating minions, those go into the collection because they are leaving play. So a minion defeated will go to the collection, and we might need to start removing those also so we don't lose the game. But that's enough of the mechanics of the scenario. Let's just start playing. So we start with 8 threats actually. I played this as solo last time, so we put 8 threats onto the main scheme. And we still need to put the health back up, so we start with 23 health on the collector. 26, I mean. So and the first ability of the collector was that we put the cards into the collection that leave play and are discarded. Okay, let's draw our opening hands. Rocket Raccoon is again the first player. So let's see, we have reload, particle cannon, relentless assault, booster boots, fug, and cybernetic skeleton. I think we could discard these, and I don't know if we need the reload. Yeah, reload is not that useful at the start. Or we could double shot with the particle cannon, maybe. I think I'll discard it. So we'll draw four cards. And we have Into the Fray, Rocket's Pistol, Battery Pack, Looking for Trouble, Particle Cannon, and Cybernetic Skeleton. Groot. Those there. Groot gets Lashing Vines, Genius, Desperate Defense, Rocket Raccoon, Dauntless, and Depth Focus. I'll keep the Depth Focus, Dauntless, the double resource, and this. We draw Depth Focus and Strength. Well, not the best use of the double resources, but it is what it is. I think Groot will set up first turn and not go up to hero mode right away. So yeah, I think that's our plan. We start with the Rocket Raccoon. I think I'll play the put the cybernetic skeleton into play. I'll play the battery pack. I won't play the particle cannon this turn. I'll play it next turn. And we get three more health. And we'll flip to hero mode, and we're ward for two. And that's Rocket's turn done, so this particle cannon is in our hand, not in play. And then Groot will put two growth counters on himself. We'll play Death Focus. We'll play Dauntless, and we'll play Lashing Vines. That is the whole turn. We ready up. We draw back up to 5 on 6 on Groot. Then we get Fruition, Indomitable, Starhawk, Heart to Ignore, Desperate Defense, and Vine Spikes. And Rocket gets... I've got a plan. Another Rocket's Pistol, Groot Ally, and Hand Cannon. Okay, let's see what the villain phase brings us. So we add two threats, the main scheme. The collector will attack Rocket Raccoon. I won't defend. So 1+1, so 2 damage. And then collector will scheme against Groot. So we reveal this card after this activation ends. So it gives 1, so 3. So we are at 10. Then we reveal this card. That's the Collector. When Collector would take any amount of damage, put this card face up into the collection, prevent all of that damage, then place threat on the main scheme equal to the amount prevented. Okay, so that was the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. And Groot is the first player. We'll start by adding growth. Then we'll play fruition to add more growth. I think now we are ready to flip. We will use depth focus to play vine spikes. Then I'll use desperate defense to play heart to ignore. And I'll use Torhawk to play indomitable. And I think actually, let's back up. I don't want to play the indomitable, so I'll use these two to return this card into Rocket's deck. So I spend two resources of any type to return a card from the collection back into the owner's deck. Then Groot will hit. So we put this into the collection. We add two threat onto the main scheme. And we start Rocket's turn, because Groot has nothing more to do. So I'll use Groot ally to play Rocket's pistol. I'll use the hand cannon to play. I've got a plan. After I ward for two, I ready, get plus one and ward again, so ward for five. And we'll keep the particle cannon. And I might as well deal two damage to the collector. And that is our turn. We ready up. Draw back up to five on Groot. Get fighting fit, flora and fauna. I am Groot and the power of protection. And Rocket gets we have the particle cannon, we get follow through salvage. I've got a plan and looking for trouble. Okay, well, we start the villain phase. We add a two threat to the main scheme. Collector attacks Groot. I will defend with Groot. 1+0. We take no damage. I'll trigger hard to ignore. And also I'll use the lashing vines. So we remove one threat. Two counters, ready Groot. Then Collector attacks Rocket, Groot will defend. 1+1 is 2, we still take no damage. We retaliate again, and now we just can't remove that. But we retaliated twice, so I remove 2 on the Collector. And encounter cards. First one is View of the Cosmos. View the Cosmos. When revealed, choose one. Put the highest cost card from your hand face up into the collection. Discard the highest cost card from your hand. Then place threat on the main scheme equal to its printed cost. The highest cost card, I'll just put the fighting fit to the collection. We have not, don't have enough resources to play both, so might as well. And we get the Vandarian Power Wand. It's an attachment artifact attached to the enemy with the lowest scheme. Hero action, spend 3. energy resources, discard this card, so we attach it to collector, because there are no other enemies. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We put Rocket Raccoon as the first player this turn, then I've got a plan, Dwarf for 2, later I've got a plan ready, and Dwarf for 3. Then I will play Salvage and follow through to put Particle Cannon into play. And I'll use the Particle Cannon to deal 4. And I'll also use the Rocket Pistol. So I'll just... So 6 in total. And I'll use the rocket, the battery pack to put a charge back to the particle cannon. And that's Rocket's turn done. We'll go to Groot. Groot will play Flora and Fauna and actually add 2 counters here. And then Fighting Fit to deal 5 damage. Or actually, do I have a... I don't have any way to remove that, but let's keep it in play. That is the hero phase done. We ready up our cards. We have another heart to ignore. Wine Shield, Root Stomp, I am Groot and Root Stomp. And chase them down, Relentless Assault, Rocket Launcher, Booster Boots, and Cannon. Okay, and we add 2 threat to the main scheme. Collector attacks Rocket Raccoon, Groot will defend. Collector hits for 3 damage, we take no damage, so we retaliate 1, remove 1 threat. And I'll spend 2 to ready Groot. Collector hits Groot, I'll defend. And no damage comes through, and we retaliate for 1. And the collector is down to 9 health on phase 1. Encounter cards, we have this in play, so Rocket gets 2. First one is artifact. Obedience potion attacks to your identity. That's character gets -1 thwart, attack and defend. Hero action, take 1 damage and spend 2 mental resources, discard this card. Any player can do this. So I'll just place it over here. And the Beyonder's Blazer. So attached to the enemy with the highest scheme, we get this boost icon. Hero action, place 2 threat on the main scheme and spend 2 resources of any of the same type, discard this card. Okay. And the Groot gets Servant Bot. Okay, well, that was the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. So Groot is the first player this turn. I think we need to get rid of at least that Servant Bot. So I'll use the focus. We don't have that much threat, so I'll use the I'm Groot to play Root Stomp and deal 4 damage here. So this guy goes into the collection and we get 1 growth counter. for defeating an enemy with the Root Stomp. Then I think we play the hard to ignore. I don't really need that. Keep this for next turn. And that is Groot's turn. Yeah, just checking that I didn't have mental resources to remove that, but Rocket Raccoon will definitely remove this by discarding booster boots, chase them down, and taking one damage. So this goes into the collection. There are 5 cards in the collection, so we need to be mindful that if we get to 10 we lose. So I think we are not playing these cards, so I'll use the Relentless Assault and Hand Cannon to return a card from the collection. And I think that is all we can do. I'll thwart for 2. I will use the Particle Cannon, deal 4, and Rocket's Pistol to deal another 2. And that is our turn. We ready up. So we have Root Stomps for days, which is quite good. We start the villain phase, we add 2 threats here. Collector attacks Groot, I will defend, and we take no damage. It's 2, now I remember this one. So 1 plus 2 is 3, and we have a 3 defense. I will trigger the hard to ignore twice and retaliate and use 2 growth counters to ready, and I will defend against the attack to Rocket. So collector hits for 1 plus 3, so 4. We'll just remove 1 growth counter, but we'll retaliate for 1, and that is the whole turn for the attacks, and we'll get encounter cards, and we still get 2 because of this damn scepter or whatever it is. Rocket will flip an exhaust to get rid of the Crisis of Half-World and assault. So the collector assaults us. I will take damage, 1 damage. Oh, too bad. So I also take 1 damage from the Star Shark, which is just silly. Okay, and Rocket gets Philosopher's Stone, hinder 2, victory 0 when defeated. Player who defeated this scheme may draw 2 cards. So it has hinder 2, so 4 plus 3 is 7. Okay. Well, that was that turn. Let's go to the next turn. So Rocket is the first player. I think we have too much resources in hand to play anything, so I think we are just flipping back to hero mode. Then I'll spend 2. Actually, do I have a? Yeah, I'll spend 3 lightning bolts to get rid of this one. Then I will spend two... actually... I'll place two threat on the main scheme. And spend two resources to get rid of this one. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cards in the collection. Then I will just won't hit for. Actually, I'll use the battery pack. Put the charge here and shoot the collector to phase 2. In player order, each player must choose to either put the top card of their deck face up into the collection or take 3 damage. And when a card would be placed, yeah, that's the same. So I think Rocket will take the damage. And Groot will take the damage. Yeah. And the collector has 28 health. So we shoot with the particle cannon to remove 4. And that is Rocket's turn done. We'll go to Groot. We have no growth counters, so I'll use the death focus and I'll use the We Are Groot to play Groot Stomp. Deal 5. And then I will use the... actually... yeah, I'll use the energy to play the other root stomp. We are halfway there. And... I think I... can call for action to Groot can't do the second remove from collection because we already did it once and it's limit once per round per player. Okay, I think that's all we can do with Groot. I'll flip Groot to alter ego. We ready up our cards. I'll add 2 growth counters here. I'll keep this in hand. We get fruition, the power of protection, fighting feats, dauntless and fertile ground. 3 cards with Rocket into the fray, chase them down. Flora and Fauna and Rocket Launcher Booster Boots. Okay, now we go to the villain phase. We add 2 threats to the main scheme. Collector attacks. I think I won't defend, so 2 plus 1 plus 1, so 4 damage. Ouch, I think Rocket needs to go heal soon. Okay, let's ready everything. Yeah, and then we will scheme for 3 plus 2, so 5. So we are at 11. Okay, encounter cards. Advance, not that nice to see. And we scheme for 5. And psionic ghost, so you are confused. Well, really doesn't matter that much. And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. Yeah, I forgot to ready Groot. Okay, so Groot is the first player. We start by adding 2 growth counters here. Groot will heal to full. We'll add 2 more growth counters. And I'll use the Dauntless to play 30 round, add 1 more growth counter here to draw a card. And we will flip. I will fighting fit for 2. Deal 5 damage to the collector. And we go to Rocket. I think Rocket will play Flora and Fauna. And we'll add growth counters. Okay, so we have 10. We are at maximum. Actually 9. One way from maximum. Then I will just ignore the psionic ghost at the moment. I will discard 2 cards to remove a card from the collection, so we don't accidentally lose for that. And then I will thwart for 2 here. And I will use this to deal 4 damage here. And that is our turn. We ready up. We'll draw back up to full. I am Groot. Left focus, indomitable, and tangling points, and hard to ignore. Rocket gets 4 cards into the fray. Thruster boots, Sunder Freude, and battery pack. Go to the villain phase. We add 2 threat here. Groot will defend. Collector hits for 2, plus if there are 3 or fewer cards in the collection, put that card of your deck face in collection. Well, there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so we put the top card of my deck in the collection. And we don't take any damage. We will trigger both of the heart ignores to remove 2 and retaliate for 1. And I will use 2 growth counters to ready Groot. I will defend for Rocket. So 2 plus, put Psionic Ghost in the play, engage with you. Now I'm a bit confused because I play so little two-handed nowadays. I have forgotten that does this come into play with Rocket or Groot. I have to check that out after. It doesn't really matter. Let's put it into play. I think we become the target if we defend. Okay, so we do it like this. Then these guys attack. Both take retaliates. Oh yeah, and collector takes 1 retaliate also. And we lose 2 counters here. That's all fine. We get. I'll use the 2 to ready, because just in case we get something bad. And let's see, this first, we get Star Shark, Quick Strike. Okay, so 3 damage. We drop down to 8. I could defend for that, but I won't. And Cloak of the Hercules. Attack to the enemy with the lowest attack. I'll just put it on this guy. Don't have to worry about that. Well, that is the villain phase. We can defeat Collector easily on the next hero phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, so Rocket is the first player. I will just end the game. So we use the particle cannon to defeat the Collector. So that was the second scenario in the Galaxy's Most Wanted box, the Infiltrate the Museum scenario against the Collector. I think I will be referring this scenario as the Collector scenario, but of course the next one is also Collector scenario, but yeah, maybe I'll think of something else. But I think the collection is an interesting mechanic. You have to be mindful of not letting it grow too large one. So we had 5-6 cards in the collection, so when it reaches 10 we would lose. Also, if we get to 20 here we would lose, so that is quite nasty, at least on true solo. So the limit for the collection in true solo is only 5 cards and the threat is only 10, so this is a really tough scenario as true solo. But as a two player, I think this is completely okay scenario. Not that hard, but makes you do some decisions to not play a card and spend resources to remove cards from the collection. So an interesting mechanic. Hope you guys like this playthrough. Next up we have the second Collector scenario, which is Escape the Museum. So we will play that next time. So thanks for watching and until next time.